Hello, my name is Rebecca Chukwuanuku. I'm a Minopedia ambassador, and today with us we have a guest.
Okay, I'm Claire Hoving. I'm a South African scientist based in Cape Town, and we're affiliated with the MRC Center for Medical Mycology Research, and I've recently started a research group, and we focus on AIDS-related fungal infections in Africa.
So how did you develop an interest in fungal immunology, pneumocystis?
After my first postdoc, I decided I wanted to stay in neglected infectious diseases. So I joined Gordon Brown, an excellent scientist, for a second postdoc, where I was introduced to fungal immunology and the devastating burden fungal infections have in Africa.
Yes, that's a good point. Fungal infections are often neglected. They have a lot of statistics showing the number of people who suffer and die from fungal infections, yet they receive scant attention. What do you think about this, and what do you think can be done to give more attention to these infections?
Yes, that's right. They're often neglected infectious diseases, and I think it's because people don't really think of them as serious infections. They often think of them as skin infections, especially in the developed countries where invasive fungal infections aren't that common. And I think to create more awareness and advocate for awareness of fungal infections in the broader research community will help our field, and also creating funding in that field will create a broader research pool of people researching fungal infections.
So what advice would you give upcoming immunologists who are interested in fungal infections?
I think if you have an interest in fungal immunology, your research can make tremendous impact, because it's such a huge problem with very few researchers in the field. And also because of that, it's quite a small community, so you will get a lot of support from other fungal immunologists in the field.
Women scientists often face challenges. Yeah, every researcher faces challenges, but women often have to face the challenges of the home front and other things, you know, that are peculiar to women. So what advice would you give to upcoming women scientists?
Yes, I agree. It can be very challenging starting a lab, and that often coincides with having a young family as well. But I think if you find a research question that you really love, a field that you love, it may take you a little bit longer, but you'll still get there, and that's what matters in the end.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's been nice having you here. Thank you.
You're most welcome. Yeah.